possible when you're trying to deal with technology. What have we got here? Okay, I think we're good. Alright. Oh, there we go. Okay, now it's showing up for me on Twitch, which is good, so we can actually maybe get something started, which would be cool. Let me double check the sound and everything sounds decent. Okay, I can't hear any music, so let's see if we can turn the volume up and see if that's any better at all. I don't know if that music is different or not. Let's find out. I think that's better. All right, I think we'll go with that. Let's double check in the other one. Bit delay, so I'm just gonna wait for it to catch up. Okay, so just trying to catch to see if it's working or not, but it's kind of giving me some struggles here. Okay, I think we're good. All right, we're gonna go with it. We'll go with it. Turn that down. Put that away. And yeah, okay, we got Twitch chat and good. Okay, so today we're doing watercolor palette setup. I just bought a new little travel palette and some paints to fill it with. I don't think I like this music, honestly. That's a bit nicer. We'll do that. So we're gonna go through and... Sorry, I'm just trying to decide if I like this music or not. Yeah, that'll do. Down a little bit. Okay, so I bought a bunch of cute little colors because I've been staring at all these cute watercolor palettes that you can buy online, like pastel palettes and like macaron palettes, and just kind of cute little selections of colors that aren't your traditional colors, because I currently owned a little palette and I really like this one. It's another Winsor & Newton, and I bought a bunch of Winsor & Newton paints because they seem to work really well for me. But this one, I've used it a ton. Had really traditional colors, but a really good selection. I don't know if you can still buy this set, but if you can, I loved it because it came with a little brush, which I wore out because I way used it too much. So I just use my regular brushes now. But it also... Okay, music. I'm not liking this. Sorry, guys. A different playlist or something. Let's try this. Better maybe. It's like a little more backgroundy. That was a little too aggressive. I don't know. A little too rough for me. That seems better. Let's turn it down a little bit though. Okay. So, this is my old palette, and I love the colors in it, but as you can see, I've used a lot of them. This one just fell out, and it got lost, and I don't know where the color that was in there went, but that's cool, because I'm going to fill it with pink, which is a color this palette doesn't have, and I would actually really like to have in this palette, because I used the red to make pink, and I've worn out all the red, which sucks, because I just used it for pink, and I could just make a pink one. So that's one thing I will be doing today, is refilling that. But I will also be making my own custom little palette, which is exciting. I put little paint pans in here, this box, but this is the box it came in. And it's a really nice little metal tin. It actually has a little hook on the back, which is cool. So you can actually put your thumb through and kind of use it if you're using it on the go somewhere, if you're out and about, which is really cool because I do actually like to go to the park and paint and stuff. So, which is nice. I didn't really get a chance to do much this summer because the weather was so terrible, but I will be doing more in the future. And also, I'm hoping to get out next week. There's one nice day next Wednesday, and I'm going to take it. I'm going to go. I'm going to paint a whole bunch. I'm going to sit in the sunshine for the last time this year and just really enjoy it. So that's my plan. Okay, so for right now, I bought a bunch of cute little colors. I'm also taking some pictures for my Instagram, because I had a cute little idea to do for Instagram. So I'm going to be, you're going to see me taking a bunch of pictures for stuff too. Okay. Try to get less reflection on here. Okay. So I wanted to do kind of like a tap through for all the different. Parts of filling the palette. So kind of like a quick little photo how-to. So, and then to do one with them kind of cutely arranged inside. Be showing you the real how to fill it as well, but for right now I'm just taking cute pictures. Back to it. There we go. Okay, I think we're back in business. As I was saying, I also have a white gouache which I am going to add to this palette as well. Because that's just a useful color and I already have it in a tube, so might as well. Okay, colors out. I have a whole bunch of these. Technically, this will fit 12 half pans. It'll fit more if you just keep shoving them in, but I'm only going to use 6 or 7 today because that's the paints I bought. I didn't... I mean, this stuff is so stupid expensive for, like, this is so tiny. This is 5 milliliters, and honestly, that will get me multiple pans out of 5 milliliters. You think this is quite a lot, but these are technically, I think, 1.5 milliliters. So you can get, what, 3 milliliters, 4.5. Yeah, you can get 3 full pans out of a 5 milliliter tube of watercolor, which is good, because these tiny 5 milliliter tubes run from, like, I don't know, $10 to $30, which is crazy. And then, you know, if you get the slightly bigger or the even bigger, it all just starts adding up real quick, especially depending on what pigment you're getting, because some of the pigments are more expensive than others, even for the same size. So it's worth keeping your eyes open when you're shopping, because you sometimes you pick one up and you're like, oh, this is small, it won't be cheap. And then it's like $40, and you're like, oh, okay, I don't need that specific pigment that badly. But these were a pretty good price. I think this was maybe $10, and these were like, I don't know, $5 for the whole set of them, which is pretty good. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And you could fill this with full pans too, which are double the size of this instead if you wanted, but these are fine. like I said, this palette I've had for ages is half pan set, and I've had this for at least a year, probably 2 years, and like I still have half, if not more, of all of these colors except red and yellow. So watercolor just lasts for friggin' ever. Like, I mean, I don't even know how much you would need to go through watercolor wise in order to need one of those giant tubes the same way you do for oil or acrylic. I guess if you're doing really big watercolors, but yeah, honestly, these ones just, you just don't need it. Okay, so I'm trying to fit 7 of these in here, so I guess we'll do 4 on top and 3 on the bottom. Sounds like a plan. And again, I'm going to take these out and actually fill them before I put them back in again. But actually, maybe I shouldn't, because they're going to be full of liquidy goo, and then I'm going to have to poke at them with my fingers. Maybe I should leave them in the pan to fill. If anyone knows, let me know. What works better if you've ever done this before. I have not actually filled my own half pans before, so I'm excited. I've worked with liquid watercolor before, but always just straight putting it on a palette and like painting directly off of that palette, rather than actually filling my own little tin or little pan. So this is new for me, but it's really easy, so thought I would show you guys. And that way you get exactly the colors you want, because I mean, you can see these are all kind of really pastel-y colors. They're really pretty kind of colors. I just wanted some of the colors you really don't try to show. I have no idea where my camera is. Try to show that off. You know, the kind of colors that you don't necessarily get in a regular painter's palette. Like this one, you know, it has like a more standard rainbow, and I wanted a cute pastel-y one so I can do pretty flowers and all the kind of stuff I like to draw. And I'm so mad because I ordered this gorgeous watercolor set of paints online, I don't know, maybe 6 months ago now, maybe probably back in March, something like this, 6 months ago, oh my god. And it never arrived. And then I called the company and I emailed the company and they emailed back and they said they would look into it, and then I never heard back from them, and then I emailed them again, I never heard anything. So I was a little mad about that. It wasn't expensive, it was probably $30 or $40, but I really wanted the paints because I had all these beautiful like blues and pinks that I love and don't own in watercolor right now. And so I got fed up and bought my own, made my own palette. But I was so mad about that because I was really excited to try them out, because everyone who had that palette on Instagram was making these beautiful, beautiful pictures because the colors just go so nicely together. But we'll make our own and it will be even better. Now, what am I doing? Am I just gonna pour the paint in? Oh yeah, it's also about how I'm trying to decide how I wanna arrange the colors to look nice. Maybe I should just do 5, 6, and 1. Cause that's kinda, and then the white can be on its own down here. But that's kinda how I visualize it. Maybe the white should be on the top. Just gonna rearrange and take my time and make it look nice. These are really easy. You just kind of pop them in and out, so it really doesn't matter. Also, I'm pleased with this palette because it has a mixing spot in the top. It has a mixing spot in the bottom. So you've really got quite a bit of room to work with, which is cool. To blend everything out. Okay, I think that'll work. Yeah, I mean, I think the fun part next, let's actually squeeze these things into tubes, or into pans. This one not moving. It's all just metal, so sometimes it's stiffer than it should be. That one doesn't want to fit in nicely. Yeah, that's a little wonky. That's okay. That's okay. It allows it to be a little wonky. It could be weird to have just the one on top, but we'll survive. Okay, let's fill it up. Ooh, this is so exciting. Okay, oh my god, they're so nice to open because they've never been opened before. Whereas I'm sure if you've ever tried to open a paint that you've left closed for a year or two, frustrating as hell. Or oil paint that you've left closed for any, acrylic actually, that you've left closed for any amount of time. Now we're just gonna squeeze it in, make it good. Actually, I think I do have toothpicks right here. I should just use a little toothpick to kind of scooch it down. But I mean, it's really this easy. Like, actually, I'll pour them all in first and then use a toothpick. That'll be much cuter. Grab some photos along the way so it'll look neat. Bloop. All right, orange next. Oh, these are so tiny and cute. I've actually never bought paints in tubes this small, but because I know I don't go through watercolor quickly, even though I use a lot of it, I thought this was the correct amount. Try to keep it from... There we go, suck it back in. But yeah, no, I squeezed out a full pan's worth, and this is still full up to here, so really, you really get quite a bit for what you do pay for. Oh, photograph. I'm going to forget one of these, I know it. But as of now, I'm getting them all. Now, I really hesitated on what yellow to buy. This one's almost a little... this one's almost a little bit orangey, a little bit goldeny, but it went well with the other colors that I had, and I almost went with more of a lemony yellow, but I think this one will do. And I'll show you what I already have in my other palette. In this one, it is more of a lemony yellow, which I guess that is the one I use the most. Damn, because I have kind of an orangey one, but that's more... That might be the exact same color. I think it's darker, though. I've used that one quite a bit, too. So I might need to go buy another yellow paint, but which I can do because I haven't filled all 12 of these yet, so I've got kind of some leeway to add new color. And that's kind of one of the things I wanted to do, too, was the nice thing about these kind of palettes is you can change as you go. Like, if you're not using a color, you can switch it out for a different color. If you need a color that you don't have, you can just go at it and grab a new path pan. And then once these are dry, which they will dry in their little pans, it's really easy to take them out and switch them, just like these guys. You can switch these out of here if you want. Most of these are kind of stuck in there now because there's paint all over, but it's just watercolor paint, so if you just push them a little bit, the pans will fall out, and I think, yeah, this one just comes out easy because it's not really attached to anything. Also, the way I lost this was I dropped the whole thing, and every paint went everywhere, and all the paints fell out of their little pans, and then, yeah, it was gone forever, but, but I found all of them except one, and I still have no idea where that one is. This is coming along so cute. Oh, I'm so excited to use it. You can actually use it right away, too. You don't have to wait for it to dry or anything. Like I said, I've used liquid watercolor straight onto a palette before. And not had any problems with that. Watercolor is super versatile. Oh, this is such a beautiful color. Oh, I'm so pleased with this blue here. It's going to be absolutely gorgeous to work with. Pretty purple. But yeah, so it doesn't take very long and you get exactly the colors you want to work with. This already looks beautiful. I'm really excited to start working with this. And some white at the end. Oh, a little bit oily, which is interesting. Oh, I'm just squeezing out more oil. Cool. Not really what I wanted to do, but here we go. Cute! Oh, now it's all, okay. Now it's all filled. Basically, I just wait for it to dry. Actually, I'm gonna use a toothpick to kind of, squish them down a little bit, mix them in. bubbles go away. There we go. Reuse the other end of this. May have filled too much of the pink in here. It's a little bit higher than the rest, but that was my first one, so I was still experimenting. Cute. Okay, we'll just get rid of that. But yeah, I was dumb. I went to the art store because I just needed a new sketchbook, because I ran through my last little sketchbook and I loved using it. It was so much fun. And I want to do, I don't know, are we allowed to say Inktober anymore? Like, I want to do some version of that hashtag controversy. So I needed a new one because I want to do it in that, so I can just whip through a whole bunch of them in one. I mean, I'm going to do 30 of them, but I'll probably do all 30 in one sitting, or at least like 10 in a sitting, something like that, just to kind of get a bunch of things done quickly. But anyways, using the cute little sketchbook because it did me so well last year. That one I don't even need to touch. The green I don't need to touch. The blue I will scooch down a little bit. And then just, honestly, that second blue is pretty good too. I don't know if I need to get in there. I might push that red down a little bit more, honestly. Use the orange one to just get in there. Get it into the corners. It's like working with brownie batter or something. But yeah, that all looks good. Okay, one more and I'll just push the blue down a little bit. Toothpicks are cheap. Push you into the corners. And just, I think the only real benefit of pushing it down is that it'll dry nicer into the palette so that it won't want to fall out as much, which really isn't going to be an issue either way for me. But yeah, that's super cute. Oh, I'm pleased with it. I'm excited to paint something with it. You'll probably see me paint something with it very quickly. Not today, because I have a whole bunch of other streams too. In fact, next up, I'm going to be spending 10 minutes and just live streaming switching my keyboard caps. I'm actually putting the same caps on, but I'm putting different rings in, and I might as well fucking film it. So that's what's happening next. This looks super cute, and I'm super pleased. Take another set of these guys, even though I already took these ones, just so they're in the right order. And yeah, I would highly recommend doing this yourself if you use watercolor or you like would like to get into it. It's really easy, really cute. Once this dries, this will be super portable. If you get one of these little, I'm actually going to buy some nice flippable watercolor brushes, like the ones with the real metal and wood, but that you can put inside of itself. For something I can fit in this tin, which will be really nice to be portable. And then you can either, like this one, if you buy these ones, you can actually just fill it with water and that's all you need. Like you can just use the water in here if you're not painting too much, or you bring a water bottle with you and keep refilling it, or you bring some form of other water storage, like a water bottle, for instance, and just a little dish kind of thing, and use that with a regular brush. Like I said, one of the convertible regular brushes that doesn't actually have the water storage field, but will work to just protect itself inside a tin. So that's what I would recommend. I love these guys. Actually, I love this palette so much, except it didn't have pink, honestly, and it didn't have a nice light blue. So those are the only two colors I really needed. The rest of these I almost pretty much already had, except for that. This looks really orange, but it's going to be a beautiful peachy kind of pink, which I wanted. It's actually really light pink. I've recently learned my favorite form of pink is, I have two favorite forms of pink. Of course I do. Hot pink, and then millennial pink is actually really a kind of a light shade of orange, honestly. So I wanted to make sure I included one of those. So that'll be beautiful. Okay, I think this one's about done. That's it. That's how to make your own little palette. It looks super cute. I'm really excited to use it. Actually, I should test it out for you just so you can see what the colors look like. Let's grab my nice sketchbook. This is not the one I rebought today. This is one I've had for a while, and I love it. It's such a nice watercolor sketchbook. I've got some beautiful paintings in here. Lovely things. If you're on my Instagram, you'll see all these guys. But for right now, let's just do a test with these things. We'll do some form of some watercolor using all of them. What do I want to? Yeah, I'm actually almost out of this book. I only have like 4 pages left, so let's use it well. We'll do something pretty. Oh, this watercolor is really nice. I could technically use the back pages of these guys. No problem. What have I already done in here? Let's check my... No, I don't have that. Okay. Everything out of the way. Oh, my drink! We have this great cider. It's like rosé mixed cider. Oh, you can't see it on the camera. That's a shame. It's this beautiful pink color. And it looks so pretty in my little floral summer wine glasses. Well, they're not wine glasses, but I use them as wine glasses in the summer because I think they're so pretty. Okay, we'll brush. Probably... This one has got a real nice tip to it. We'll try this. I think this one's kind of shitty. It's kind of like fluffed out at the end. We'll give it a try. I don't think I've used it in a while. This one's really good, but it's a little too big. I actually need to invest in a mid-size one with a really nice quality tip on it. But I have not done so yet with my water jar. That's a jar of glitter. It's not water at all. The things you find in my house. This is water. Well, it's gonna be. It's empty now. That water. What should I draw? Don't have all my reference photos that I wanted. Like that I've seen from other artists that I want to do are all in the phone that's currently being used to record this, so that doesn't help me. And this phone's not big enough to keep all of my photos on the cloud on it because I have like 20,000-30,000 photos or something, and I could put them all on this phone. Actually, it's a pretty big phone, but if I do, then I run out of space when I'm trying to record video on this, which hopefully it won't be a problem in the future if the tablet starts working. Also, I'm going to get a new tablet pretty soon, which is very exciting because I will have the Apple Pencil. I'm so excited to get to use Apple Pencil. Because obviously everyone on the internet, every artist on the internet has an Apple Pencil, and I need to... It just looks really fun and really cool. I mean, I just use... I do use Procreate on my tablet with just a regular stylus, but it's not even like a nice stylus with like a tip on it. I didn't even invest in one of those. It's just like a regular stupid pen stylus. So I was gonna be like, okay, well, I'll invest in like a nice quality stylus tip and like one of those gloves you can get so your hand doesn't show it. But then I thought, let's just get the new goddamn iPad. That'll be nice, and honestly, at this point, I need as many cameras and screens as I can to get all this stuff kind of working. So, let's paint something real quick, just something pretty. All this. Try to make sure it's still working nicely. I think it is. Okay, what are we gonna paint? I don't want to ruin my pretty little palettes here, so I'll be sparing. And again, you can be so sparing. You just don't need that much watercolor to make things work. Okay, I just saw someone who did a really kind of beautiful blue and pink kind of lily thing. I wonder if I could find that image. I know what it is I want to paint and I need the reference. So let's just use good old Dropbox and find this specific image that I want to paint. That would make a lot of sense, wouldn't it? Okay, da-da-da, photos. Oh my god, and I recently had to go through and actually take photos out of my Dropbox photo automatic update folder because, again, it was like tens of thousands of photos and it was completely unusable on the computer. That folder just froze every time you opened it. So now it doesn't freeze because I've took all the photos out before this year and put them in separate folders. So they're still on my Dropbox, they're just not in the photos folder. Come on, Dropbox, work for me, baby, work for me. Files. Oh, do I have to go to files because it's not technically... Oh, because this phone's not uploading photos to Dropbox. So I have to go to my actual... To the actual folder. Camera uploads. That's the one. I'll find something pretty. Yeah, I've got a lot of streaming to do today. So if you are hanging around later, like I said, I'm doing the keyboard immediately after this. That's only going to be like 10 minutes long. However long it takes me to flip my keys. And then later I'm going to be doing something, maybe, a fall capsule collection might be happening today because I have to pack for a trip anyways, which is the same thing. Like a vacation wardrobe is the same thing as a capsule wardrobe essentially. So, I think we're going to do that. So I have to be, the trip is going to be in a week, but there's some other stuff I need to film too. Like I need to film setting up my sewing station, which I've been putting off for ages. And I need to film, can I flip the order? No, I cannot. Okay, just taking its sweet time to load everything. Of course it is, because like I said, I have a million photographs. What else do I need to film today? Many things, many a thing. There we go, that's more recent stuff. That's not even recent stuff. What is that? What is all this? Okay, good. There we go. My photos are organized solely by date, so sometimes I can't find things. But, oh, I'm also so excited. I just ordered, okay. I'm going on a trip, like I said, and so I'm like, okay, well, I need to be able to work on my trip, and I work in Microsoft Word for my job. And I need track changes, and you can do that on a tablet, but if you don't pay for Microsoft Office, it like limits, like you can work with a track changes document, but you can't change it from track changes to not. And obviously I need to be able to put a document into track changes before I edit it. So I'm like, okay, I'll have to pay for that, and I'll get a little connector to use just my regular USB keyboard with the iPad. But then I started looking at like, oh, would it be easier just to get a really cheap small laptop, like a $300 laptop to bring instead, you know, that has its own keyboard and stuff and all that kind of thing. And what I ended up finding was the smallest pink little laptop. And it was not $300, it was closer to $1,000, but it's like the size of an iPad mini, and it works as a tablet. So, it really caught my eye, and it's kind of like a dumb thing because it's so small that like keyboards hard to use, and it's like, you know, but it's fully Windows powered, so it technically will run things like full, Photoshop and stuff like that and full video editing because it's a full computer. So I thought that would be useful. There it is. This is the painting I saw recently. And it is. It's irises. It's beautiful. So I'll just show it briefly because this isn't my work. This is the work of an artist online who I thought it was just gorgeous. Thanks, Dropbox. Not now. I thought it was just gorgeous. So I'm going to try to do something like this. It's kind of got blues and greens and purples and yellows and pinks and all of these colors. So it's going to be really nice. What have we got here? Now, this is a different style. Obviously, this is more of like an acrylic or an oil style, so all the colors are kind of blended together, but I'm going to do it in watercolors and just kind of keep them... I thought I was working horizontally, but I'm not, apparently. And just kind of keep them more separated. And like, I probably won't even add that background in there. So let's do... Let's do the yellow section first. I don't know. What do we got here? There we go. Pretty light. A bit more. Down here. So you guys can see that. But I would highly recommend this sketchbook. What is it? Show you guys before I started. It's a Strathmore sketchbook in this cute little size, and it's been really nice to work with. Let's get a little bit of orange. The trick to doing watercolors is to leave lots of white space in between colors. It's kind of the trick to making everything look good. Oh yeah, this orange is beautiful. It's a really nice kind of peachy orange, which is what I wanted. I didn't want something like orange. Okay, let's grab some pink next. Oh, that's vibrant. That's fun. Yeah, that's nice there. Okay, a little bit of purple next. No, I don't know, maybe I should have done the background ones first, but too late now. I'm trying to do this without messing up the little tints too much. Sugar hair on my brush. And the nice thing about watercolors, you don't need to worry too much if you do kind of overlap a bit. Like, the colors will nicely bleed into each other, which is kind of a cool effect on its own, so. Oh yeah, this is looking great. I'm quite pleased with this. Okay, now I want all the background leaves are green and blue and a little bit more purple, so. Oops, I'm going to drag some of the pink over there. That's okay, though. I won't hurt it. Probably some pink flowers over there. see. Color into this part. Now this used a really dark blue at the back there, so let's use a nice dark. Dark purpley wash back here. And now I'm just not letting it touch the lines I've already drawn. Well, a little bit. But mostly just trying to okay. A lot more green. And here. Yeah, I'm glad I grabbed this brush because it really does have a lot of that really thin tip on it, so I can get kind of these nice little green spikies going. Not enough water. And yeah, so if you get that where you get like a highly pigmented drop there, just add more water and you can just make it do whatever you want. And then over here I don't have enough pigment, so I'll go back and add some more in. Up because everything should be little lines. Now for detail-wise, I want to put the brightest colors in the front. So that's going to be the three flowers and the greenery at the front. And I want to leave those background colors a little more dull. So I was just about to go in and put more green on there, but I'm like, no, leave it lighter. That'll actually look better. No, I thought a bit more down here, though. Yeah, kind of nice dark green down here. And then we're going to go over all this with them, that nice darker blue color. It's kind of interesting. I haven't really done a watercolor like this before. It's more like my acrylic works, which is interesting. About this one. I'm not sure I'm liking the background anymore, but we'll keep working with it. Maybe it'll come around. That's better, honestly. it's kind of an experiment for me, but it's all right. And again, working kind of more of that acrylic style, which is kind of interesting, honestly. My color wash to the background here. And this paper is really good. It'll soak up the water and dry it all quickly, so. Which can be good or bad, because if you're trying to work with something that's still wet, it's already dry. But if you want something dry, it's good. Color the edges. Okay, yeah, I don't know. I think maybe I need to work over some of it a little bit stronger. Stems and a little bit more green. And then maybe if I add the little purple flowers in, that'll make it better. I guess I should wait for it to dry before I try adding anything else on here, though. I do like that blue in the middle. I think I just need more blue at the bottom here. Maybe I'll fix it. Yeah, because just to kind of draw that curve around a bit more. So I've got kind of more of an S curve of the blue color. Yeah, I think that's better. Oh, I kind of went on to the next page. Oh, well, I guess that's what's going on the next page. I'll have to work. Sometimes that's fun to just have to work around what you've already got going on. I think I might try and make these flowers a little more thick paint-wise, especially because I'm working with it in a liquid form. These are just kind of blending into the background, so let's make them a little more vibrant. Especially because some of these are like the front flowers, they should be really bright and exciting. I feel like I didn't really get a pink out of this. I didn't dilute it enough. It's very very red. Maybe a little more pink. There we go. That's a lot more pink, honestly. That's kind of a little bit different. Okay, let's add some more purple flowers now that this is a little bit drier. Yeah, I should have been starting with darker ones up front. Little ones in the background. Oh, this song's kind of nice. This looks better with some more flowers on it. I think that really helped. Because you can use watercolors more like acrylics if you want. Especially liquid watercolors, because they have that more of a three-dimensionality to them. Just kind of keep it pretty abstract for sure. Here at email, let's make cartoon. Not today, although sometimes. Check back later. Actually, honestly, later today I don't know what I'll be drawing. I might be drawing some fashion sketches, so potentially. Good. I think I need just some like big kind of purpley blue leaves. Nice thing too, if your paint dries on your palette, it's literally not a problem. Just add more water and now it's liquid paint again. That's a nice color. Oh, these colors all blend so well together. I'm super pleased with them. Okay, what do I need here? I need some of that. Some big leaves on the bottom here. Yeah, I can live with this. It's not my favorite thing I've ever done, but considering I wasn't planning on doing a painting today, deal with it. Yeah, I needed to have diluted that original pink more to make it more pink, but not bad. Don't know about all these things. Maybe I need to cover them up a bit more. Make it more of a greeny blue. I don't know, I'm worried I'm overworking it now and I know it, but I just not where I want it to be, so there's no real other solution. I'll just keep adding more stuff to it. I mean, that's the thing, if you have a picture you don't already like, no harm continuing to add to it. The harm in continuing to add to something is when you do like it, and then you're like, oh, but it could be slightly better, and then you ruin it. But for this one, I feel like any change is an improvement at this point. That's honestly better. I don't know if it looks better from where you are, but for me, that does look better to me. do like that purple in the corner. That made a big difference. And what do I need to... All these purple flowers just aren't doing it for me. If I went over them with some white. Let's just try to tone them all down a little bit. I'm literally just covering these up with a little bit of white gouache, trying to make them blend in better. I think maybe they're just too... Too much, too strong, too many. I don't know what I did. It's a bit better. That's honestly much better. I think I like that. Yeah, okay, that's not terrible. That was not the worst decision I've ever made. I think that is better with a little bit of the pink. Still not liking this corner. This corner is fucking causing trouble here. Let's try a purple green. See if I can make kind of a really dark color. A bit darker than that, even. Yeah, just like some big leaf action. That's honestly a bit better. And just some straight purple in this corner to match it to the other corner, because I like the other corner, and I don't know if it'll help if I try to emulate it, but this point it can hurt. More than that, darker please. Well, that gave this corner a little bit more interest for sure. Okay, I think I might be done. I don't know if there's too much more I can do here without causing more and more trouble. I could try to add a little bit of orange or yellow to some of these, but I am gonna get in trouble at some point here by overdoing this. This just looks like adding more pink. What about the yellow? Yellow is really nice for just adding little touches to painting. Sometimes when you think a painting is done and then you add a little bit of yellow to it, it makes the whole thing pop. So let's, let's just put a little yellow in. That's not terrible. Not terrible, considering this painting was a bit of a goner at one point. Okay. It's not the best thing I've ever done. I don't think I would, like, try to sell this or anything, but it's a good experiment, especially with the new palette. Yeah. The problem is this kind of background just doesn't work very well with watercolor, but I think it came around in the end there. I would like to kind of clear out the extra colors I've mixed into everything here. grab a Kleenex. Oops, I keep mixing more green into the head. Let's really clean the brush before. Before touching the orange, clean your brush so you don't mix green into it. There we go. That's a bit better. Okay. Okay, I think that one's about as done as she's getting. All right. Okay, well, I'm going to stop this stream. I'm going to be back very shortly to do my keyboard. And then I'll be back later in the day for something else at some point. Who knows? But thanks for everyone who tuned in. I hope you learned something. I hope you feel confident in making your own palette. It's so easy. And, you know, you can pick exactly the colors you want. Like, these still feel like they're full, even though I squeezed them out into palettes. So, honestly, definitely don't feel like you need to buy the size up. Buy the smallest liquid tube watercolor you can, and this will probably last me a year, more than a year. So yeah, buy some watercolors, make your own palette. It's really fun and really easy. And I will see you guys in a bit. Bye now.